All right, we're going to go back to the questions in just a minute, but first we'd like to welcome Kara from the Rochester Museum and Science Center to the show. Hi, Kara.
Welcome. Hi. What did you bring us?
So we brought Portis, who is our Russian tortoise.
Okay, and what's the difference between a turtle and a tortoise?
So there are a few differences, mainly where they live. So tortoises are going to live mostly on land, whereas turtles are going to live at least close to water, if not right in the water. They have different front claws here. These guys have these nice big sharp claws that they use to burrow, whereas your turtles will have webbed claws. Right. So we've got a few differences.
Cool. So this turtle is from Russia because they're Russian, really?
Yeah, Central Asia.
No kidding.
So, some from Russia.
All right. Sometimes that's not the case.
Sometimes not always the case.
Right.
Okay, what type of food does it eat and how much? It's
this
not very big.
Yeah, he's a tiny little guy, but they'll eat a lot. They're opportunists. If there's food, they're going to eat it usually. they like to eat a lot because they are used to hibernating when they're in the wild. So they will eat until they can't eat anymore usually. So you have to feed them in small doses. They like to eat vegetables. So green leafy vegetables mainly, but they love like dandelion greens. And then for a little treat, you can give them a banana or strawberry. Good.
I need a few of those in my lawn.
Right?
So climate-wise, you're saying in the Central Asia, what's the climate like there then?
They have really rough winters and also really, really hot summers.
Rochester.
Yeah. So these guys have learned to hibernate for a long period of time. They are actually known to live underground for up to 9 months out of the year if they need to. So they're only active about 3 months. They come out, they eat, breed, and then go right back to sleep.
Cool.
Wow. Okay. Compared to other tortoises, how is this one compared to size?
Small, very small. So he looks like he's just a baby. He's not. We think he's about at least 8 or 9 years old.
Really?
They'll hit full grown when they're 30, usually about. So he's very small for tortoises. Obviously, you got Galapagos tortoises that are, you know, huge.
Yeah,
exactly. Sure. 5 feet or whatever. This guy here is only going to get to be about 6 inches. He's a boy. Girls will reach up to 9.
Okay. Oh.
Okay.
Talking about length of life, how long is tortoises going to live?
This guy, at least 50 in captivity. They'll actually live to be over 100 sometimes in the wild. That is because they do hibernate for most of the year, so they are sleeping and it elongates their life. Exactly.
Right. Wow.
Why do they hibernate?
For the weather, mainly. If it's really, really cold or really, really hot, they try to get away from those extremes. These guys, because they live on land, they do burrow to get away from the heat.
Okay.
So that's what they'll do to get away from the hot, hot weather.
So being that these live so long, that's probably not a good pet to get, as cute as turtles are, tortoises are, right?
Yeah, he's adorable. We have him at the museum because, you know, somebody's always going to be there to take care of him.
Sure.
But these guys can live to be 50 years old. Sometimes they outlive their owners. People have been known to put them in their wills because they do live for such a long period of time.
Wow.
So for, you know, somebody who's 8 or 10 years old, you don't know where you're going to be in 50 years. So it's not usually a smart idea to sign up for such a large, large task.
Right.
Now, before the show, we were talking about the shell.
Yeah.
Can you give our viewers a little information about the shell?
He's got a great shell. Obviously, people know all about our tortoise shells here. One of the common myths about turtles and tortoises is that they can come out of their shell.
No.
They can't do that, at least when they're still alive. Their shell is attached to their backbone as well as their rib cage. It's all part of this big shell here, so they can't come out of it. They have a nice hard shell here that's made up of scutes, which are these circular things here.
Yeah.
Those are called scutes there. Those are actually made out of keratin, which is similar to what is in our fingernails, which is pretty interesting. So it does grow with him. So people are always wondering how their shell grows. Same way your fingernails would grow. So it's very similar. And he uses it for protection. So he'll pull his whole body right in when he gets nervous or scared.
I have red-eared turtles.
Mm-hmm.
And in the summer, I take them home and they get more ultraviolet radiation. And there's pieces of shell, so they
shed pieces of their shell, absolutely.
And as most reptiles they do.
The older they get.
As they get bigger.
Yeah.
Very
now,
cool.
Will he gain any more of these, like, does the circle get bigger
when
or do the
smaller,
pieces
he had
get
less? So,
okay, so he'll gain more and more
as he gets
bigger.
Yep.
Now,
okay.
In nature, the toenails are quite long on this guy
here. Yes, yeah, we've got
they wouldn't be like that in nature, though.
Not usually. They've got a lot of rocks and things that they climb on that will actually shorten their nails.
All right.
Mm-hmm.
Cool.
Yeah.
Thank you very much, Kara.
You're welcome.
He's cute.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Want to know more about this animal and others like it? Go to our website, homeworkhotline.org, and click on videos. Stay right there. We'll be back in a second.